a total stranger.
This is Bismuth.
Oh, just a new member of the team.
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying?
Hey, beautiful people. Big episode, big recap. Let's get right into it. Today's episode is Bismuth. In the episode, Steven accidentally unbubbles a gem sealed away in Lion's mane. When Steven pulls her out, it turns out to be one of the original crystal gems, Bismuth. Bismuth was poofed during the war and hidden away by Rose Quartz, who lied to a friend saying that she was captured or shattered. Bismuth was the original blacksmith who upgrades Pearl, Garnet, and Amethyst's weapons. The team spars off with each other, then Steven shows Bismuth some Earth activities.
It's in theaters now, coming this summer.
Two brothers in a van. And then a meteor hit, and they ran as fast as they could from giant cat monsters.
That night, Bismuth talks to Steven about his potential and how he could be better than Rose. She gives Steven the breaking point, a weapon designed to destroy gems at their core. Steven tells her that he can't shatter gems because that would make him as bad as Homeworld, and Bismuth responds that that's exactly what Rose said, and now believes Steven is Rose in disguise, and goes into a rage. She fights Steven, and in Steven's self-defense, he accidentally poofs Bismuth. Steven promises her that he'll tell her friends everything that happened.
Then you really are better than her.
The episode ends with Steven telling the Crystal Gems about what just happened, and they leave Bismuth bubbled. End of episode. So let's talk about the episode. Now, this is going to be a really weird thing to say, and everyone's probably going to be like, what? But this felt like an anime movie. Like, if anyone that watches One Piece, you know how they do, like, a yearly movie. This kind of felt like that in the sense of they added a new antagonist, and then at the end of the episode, it all went back to status quo so that it can kind of fit into the mythos of the show. Obviously, Bismuth has been in it since the beginning. We've seen since Lion's introduction that we saw her bubbled in the background. So, I mean, it's not the same thing, but how it's set up, how it's simple slice of life, then introduce something, and then we find out so much about this character, and then we just go back to status quo. We're back to just the same set of crystal gems. Granted, it looks like their upgraded weapons are here to stay, which is super exciting. As far as the weapons go, I really like Pearl's new weapon a lot. The trident thing looks, it's so good. Since Pearl's come from the ocean, that's just perfect. Garnet getting spiked knuckles, brass knuckles, basically. All right, that's cool. Not as imaginative, not nearly as neat, but hey, it works. And then, Amethyst's whip becoming more like flails. Okay, I could live it or take it. I do like the guy upgrades. I do like that the upgrades are kind of like these additional pieces that they have to be holding for them to, you know, change into it. I don't know if it's the first time they change into the weapons and, like, future versions they don't need it, but who knows. What's really cool is that, you know, Amethyst just got a stat boost, basically, and we know that she needed it from the previous episode, so that's neat. I know you guys are wanting to know what my thoughts are on Bismuth. We've known about Bismuth for a while. We knew about it because of her voice actor, which we knew from her celebrity voice actor that she's probably not going to become a regular, so I assumed she was probably going to get bubbled by the end of the episode. And really, the whole episode is just basically the mystery of what did Bismuth do to cause Rose to hide her away in Lion. No one really went in this thinking, okay, Bismuth is going to be a new main character. She's just going to pop around. They tried to make us feel like it, but you don't have a celebrity guest voice actor and then be like, oh, hey, they're going to be a regular. It just doesn't work that way. I, for the most part, I really like Bismuth. I think she's really cool. Using her name as a joke multiple times is a really quirky, fun little bait. I like her blacksmith design. Like, we kind of figured out she was a blacksmith right from the get-go because she has that apron, but it looks so good. I love it. I also like that she doesn't just have stars, but she also has kind of her own version of stars that you can see in her weapon and on her own design, which really cements the idea that she is a different fraction from Rose Quartz. Like, you know, I wouldn't be shocked if she just repoofs and tries to start her own crystal gems. But yeah, as far, like, I like the purpleness, I like the masculine traits to her, I like that her personality is very dominant, very in-your-face. I am not the biggest fan of the rainbow hair, just something about it throws off the design for me, color theory-wise. Most of the gems only have, like, two or three colors that they work, or at least four with Pearl, and she's just kind of rocking all of them. And it makes sense for a Bismuth design, because it's such a rainbow thing. It's just one of those things where No matter what, we're going to incorporate something rainbow into a design, and that is the best case scenario. I just still don't, design wise, just something about it's, you know, just kind of turned me off. I do like her shape shifting hands. Her being a blacksmith, it makes sense that she has all the weapons. She gets whatever she wants. Tools, screwdrivers, weapons, neat. I like that she has the ability to shapeshift her hands. Works so well with her personality and job. It just makes a lot of sense. I do like learning more about Rose Quartz. And so the real question I've seen a lot of people having discourse about on Tumblr is, was Rose Quartz right about bubbling bismuth? Like, obviously, killing people for the sake of a peaceful movement is definitely illogical and doesn't work. I understand what Bismuth is going for, but she was going to be damaging the cause more than she was helping. As far as bubbling her, essentially killing her off, and then telling her friends lies, I see Rose's reasoning behind it. If you step back and think about it this way, if after that fight, Bismuth was probably going to separate from the Crystal Gems and starting up a separate faction, probably ones that are more lethal. There's going to be people that's going to agree with that, and it's going to split the Crystal Gems, which was already kind of like, you know, I got the impression that there was more homeworld than there was Crystal Gems, so they're already at a disadvantage. And if they would have split the team into two different teams, they would have been doomed. A team divided just doesn't work. So for the best of the cause, it makes a lot of sense why Rose would, you know, hey, take out this problem person. As far as not telling her friends about what happened, well, doing that would have made a lot of distrust with Rose, and it would have weakened her command. As a strategy and tactical person, which we know Rose is through Jasper, it's one of those things that, like, it makes a lot of sense of what Rose's, like, ideas were. Whether or not it was morally right, that's a different story. But as far as a strategy, as far as war goes, it makes a lot of sense. What kind of irks me a little bit is the very end of this episode is so abrupt, because you have all this stuff happening, and then Steven explaining what happened, seeing the reactions. I wanted to see the Crystal Gems' reactions and have them have a discussion about what to do with Bismuth, instead of having this, like, musical montage of, like, 2 seconds. It was really short and abrupt, and I know they're running out of, you know, time, so it wasn't really a lot you could do. However, I did make a quick edit using some of the speech from the earlier of the episode, and it really kind of puts in sight what exactly happened.
It's not always easy to understand Rose's choices, but we have to stand behind them.
Garnet and Pearl, no matter what, and Amethyst as well as Steven, they believe in what Rose had to say and believe in Rose's, you know, cause. And so, hey, you know, Rose is a weird person, but we have to stand by what she said. We have to stand by her legacy. And keeping Bismuth around would have been damaging that. With Bismuth being bubbled and put in the temple instead of Lion's Mane means there's definitely going to be the return of Bismuth. There's no way around it. This is happening. I'm really curious to see if Bismuth is going to become a main antagonist, or at least a secondary antagonist within the show. Is she going to appear a couple of times? Is her and Jasper going to team up in some way? Because I feel like they're very similar, and not in what they're... Well, they both love to fight, first of all, so they would complement each other very well there. But but their ideologies, obviously, Jasper, I think, just wants to fight. At this point, I don't think she's necessarily loyal to anyone. She's on her own. And then Bismuth has also been kind of, like, ostracized from her own team. I mean, when Bismuth does come back, Pearl Garnet know what happened, and they chose Rose over her. That betrayal, Bismuth is gone. The Bismuth, as we know as a friend, is no longer going to be here. So that's my thoughts on the episode as far as everything kind of goes. It was a really good episode, great two-parter, a little rushed towards the end, but overall introduced a new character, added a lot of new elements to the show. We definitely know Rose. The big thing about Rose is that when we first saw her and she was introduced, we were told that she's perfect. Everyone just gloats about her. Everyone just kind of, you know, praises her, does all this stuff, and then you come to find out, the more we learn about Rose, the more we learn about how imperfect she was, how she didn't quite understand everything, and that's the thing you learn about people, is that, like, you know, you tend to put these people on, you know, especially, like, people that you follow, or YouTubers or something, you put these people on pedestals, because you only know what they want you to know, And then as you learn more about them, you learn both the good and the bad, you know, and they might do stuff that you don't morally agree with. And this is what Rose, we're learning that she made a lot of mistakes. And the cool thing is, as much as Bismuth was wrong in, like, her ideologies, she was right about Steven. Steven does have the potential of not just living up to Rose's shadow, but being a completely different person. That's the beauty of Steven, is that he can do what he wants, and he can learn to be a better person. And we can already see that he's taking different measures. Whether or not they're right or wrong, he's definitely taking different measures. And since it is Steven being the good guy, we're probably safe to assume he's probably doing the more morally right thing. If I forgot anything in the comment, if I forgot to mention something you thought I should have, please talk about it in the comments, and I'll try to get back with you as soon as possible. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'm off to Gen Con. I'm going to go probably spend too much money on board games, or at least play a couple. I will see you guys in the next episode. Love ya.